IVM.
If you're broke, if you need money, if you don't have a wallet, you don't have a financial portfolio, don't bother, there's no hope for you. Or is there? His name is Anupam Gupta, paisa vaisa, but don't ask him for money. I asked, he gave me nothing. New episodes out on the IVM podcast website, app, or wherever you get your podcast from.
Kripaya dhyan dijiye, the language used on the podcast may not be fit for consumption. We warn you, tread carefully. But listen, yaar, don't be so conservative.
You're listening to Cyrus Says.
All right, it's called Agla Station Adulthood. It's not about the railways. I wanted to do a whole show on the railways, but they said, no, it's too boring. I thought we just have trains going in and out for the entire show and nobody talking, but they said, no. Sponsor likes it, though, so it may come through in a bit. In the meantime, we have Rytasha Rathore and Ayushi Amin, two best friends from Cathedral School who come together and present a podcast which is going to change the life of a young adult. If you're an adult and don't know how to change your own diaper, they'll show you how.
Why follow your auntie's advice when you can follow Cyrus Says on Facebook and Twitter to stay updated about the latest shows?
All right, festive week while we record this. Lots of festivals ending with Parsinua, starting with Eid, in between India's Independence Day, if I get my dates right. And the biggest one, of course, Raksha Bandhan. The scar of mankind, as far as I'm concerned. In college, all the girls tie the thing to your hand to make sure you stay away from them. You're now brother for life. So here's my point. Since I have my own sister and cousins, I don't believe in just everybody becoming my sister just because they're from the opposite gender. So I think the government could help us on this one. The Aadhaar card should include whether you're Rakhi or Raksha Bandhan compliant or not. You should have that option right there so that people don't waste their time. Because I think it's like a little insulting after a point. The girls are in such a hurry to go, bye, bye. They find all the creeps and quickly tie stuff on them and you bye for life and they screw up your mind and then you take it out on the wife you're forced to have an arranged marriage with. So I don't want that to happen. So I want the Aadhaar card to reflect because I think that card gives us hope. There are a lot of things it can reflect. And one of them it can is whether you're Raksha Bandhan compliant. This is my request to the government. Please take it seriously. It's called Cyrus Says. We'll be right back, yeah.
Hey guys, this is me, Eva Bhatt, your host for the podcast 9XM Soundcast. This podcast is produced by India's largest music network, 9X Media. We have been catering music and you have been enjoying. And now we bring you a podcast where music inspires. Every week, I interact with some of the best minds from the music industry to understand their creative discipline. Every new episode will feature artists who will share inspiring notes from their journey, some valuable tips for budding artists. So do subscribe to the podcast where music inspires. Enjoy a brand new episode of 9XM Soundcast every Tuesday on IVM Podcast app or website or wherever you get your podcast from.
Okay, they're talking amongst themselves and I've started the damn show. The lack of respect after my Raksha Bandhan rant. Which is true, ladies, which is true. Let me quickly mention that we are talking to two of the greatest professionals of our times.
Indeed.
Two of the most wonderful and decorated officers.
Yes.
When it comes to podcasting. Yes. Which is just a list of 9 people anyway. But that's not the point. You're right at the top of the tree. Rytasha, you're back. We spoke about maybe a year back, I think.
Yes, indeed.
And it was a wonderful time for, well, one of us, namely me. Ayushi, you've joined us and you share something in common. You come from the same school where the Garib children go to. Cathedral and John Cannon School.
It's your school as well.
Yeah, you should
tell people that.
But at that time, only the rich went. I was a special category, wandering outside the gate. So we'll get to the whole thing about how you guys got together, because obviously there is same class.
Yes. We have a story.
No, same class of society.
No.
Oh, damn.
Ayushi's far wealthier.
Oops. Is
no,
that
no,
true?
No. My parents are comfortable.
Are you from the Charu Amin family?
Who is that?
Okay, oh, fair enough. When you say that, you've answered the question. There's no need to take it further. We're done. So Rytasha and Ayushi are here with us and they've got a new podcast called Agla Station Adulthood.
Yeah, you managed to say it. Congratulations, Cyrus.
A-S-A. Asa.
I like Asa. It.
Those are my initials.
Ayushi.
Yeah, it's made for me, this whole thing.
You just have to have someone saying N in the beginning. Like, Nirupama, Agla Station Adulthood. And
yes.
You go, NASA.
Yes,
there you go.
NASA.
So let's start with
both
that.
Both things we're unqualified with. Space travel or adulting.
Nobody, our listeners, for this Cyrus Says, I tell you, they don't worry about all this. Credibility has never been a factor on my show, so you don't have to worry. Okay, just go right ahead.
Can we have the same listeners so that they also don't expect credibility
actually
from us?
Do. Don't tell anyone. It's the same group of 20 people. Yeah. Okay, so let's start with that. So what is this Agla Station Adulthood, which is on IVM Podcast on every
Thursday. Dropping on the 22nd of August.
Yes.
22nd of August, whatever that means.
Thursday.
Yeah. Thursday. Now, like three retards, we'll keep going.
Every Thursday. Thursday. Yes. Thank you so much, firstly, Cyrus Bhaiya, for having us on your show.
Don't you dare tight. Do not take out that. When I see that Rakhi in a girl's hand, I feel fear, anxiety.
We also feel the fear, which is why we're tying the Rakhi.
I understand. And there are some real creeps out there. I don't blame you. But it's terrible. You don't understand how many men feel bad. How many people get what they call the KLD, at least in my generation.
What is KLD?
I don't know what it means. I forgot. I mean, I know
KLPD.
What it means. What is KLPD?
Can I say it? It's not allowed.
But it's bad. It's a bad word. And
basically,
all
it's like you have a boner and someone like
cuts it
off. Essentially. Oh damn! Khade land ped dhoka. I did it.
Oh, one second.
There.
If you were going to say, why did you translate it first?
Why did you go through
all this?
Show hai cathedral school ka.
Ayushi, walk out now. This woman is a hypocrite.
You said,
I can't believe it.
How can you first give the English and then you ruined it?
I was just warming
people
up.
And you know what? No, our listeners were happily trying to get it together. Haan, ye kya hoga, private path, this, that. They were putting it together.
They would have
and then
Googled
you went for the
it
kill.
And all.
Our
and
listeners
now
are
we have nothing
equipped
to give them.
We could have given at the end, like stick
yes,
around, we'll
lovely.
Reveal.
Why end? After a year, so they keep listening. We need to hold people.
I apologize.
Okay, 1 point deducted from Rytasha Rathore. Score, she is now minus
He's
one
so
on the balance beam. Did you have Mr. Nepali in the gymnastic department or whatever it's called?
Gymnasium? We had a very eclectic gymnastics sports, teachers who none of them looked fit enough to do it.
Oh, that's the legacy of Mr. Nepali. He never actually went on the
there
balance
was no
beam.
Mr. Nepali in our time.
Lovely cigarette in the mouth, big stomach, lovely guy. He would just clap his hands and tell you what to do. That's the kind of coach I want.
Just,
he never did it.
Every term of health right there.
Yeah, but that's okay. It's fine. He wasn't a school child. Why should he have to do... Would you, as an adult, go on the balance beam and the parallel bars and hang on the Roman rings? I mean, you're an adult, for God's sake.
I'd love to walk the balance beam now because it might be easier than actually balancing life itself.
I always wanted to do it when I was drunk. Like, really drunk. Like a test.
For what?
No, the balance beam. You know, the cops should do that. You imagine if you go back to school, go to the gym, you're completely trashed, and you then go onto the damn balance beam and you walk successfully. Tippy toe.
I think currently the achievement would be getting back into school because how they just don't allow people to go back in.
And the watchman is the most powerful member of any school now.
This is not being facetious. He's genuinely very strict.
He is. The principal's husband is not allowed in. Of course, he's been told that. You know,
he doesn't want him in.
Yeah, exactly. But no, jokes about you, right? You can't get past the watchman.
Oh, the watchman loves me.
But it's not the same watchman. Top
it
security
is.
Changes.
It's been the same security since we were in school.
No, by the way, they've changed
the other
guy.
No.
But they only like you because you're famous now.
That's
like,
true.
It's, come on.
Let's this
be,
is some rubbish going
call
on.
Let's call a spade a spade.
They're yeah. very happy.
You're really vain, Rytasha. I wanted to say it, but now that she's mentioned it,
please
I think it's fair.
Every time we talk to her now, she updates us. You know, by the way, my Instagram followers have gone up by like.
That's not true. We know that's not true after the debacle I've lived through.
What debacle? Tell us.
Oh, no.
It's not debacle?
Firstly,
Cathedral?
You were almost involved in that.
What?
Like, because I needed your help. But
what?
Then...
me?
Are you going to talk about
your...
The only thing I can help
right
you
now.
With is picking up a bag. I can't think of anything else I could
no,
do.
No, I needed your help with WSD at one point.
Oh, that I can help you with. They're sitting in my office.
Yeah, I know.
Why don't you just tell me that?
So that's it. But the
okay, now this is like KLPD.
Yeah.
You're not telling us exactly and then you're suddenly going to spit it out. So just tell me, what are you talking about?
Got into a bit of an issue with animal activists because of a dog that jumped into my auto rickshaw. And I didn't know it was wrong or whatever because I have no knowledge about
animals. Why is it
wrong? It's wrong to
displace a stray animal.
So not displace, yeah.
Correct.
Yeah, yeah.
So the dog came with me from Varsova to Khar.
You took him to another area. That's dangerous.
That's exactly. So I didn't know all this. And then...
But that's fine. You didn't know. It's no, if there's no intent to be malicious or
harmful. You would think that would have stopped people from...
But it was a shitstorm online. Anyway...
Why didn't you call me?
I was going
to... I have friends.
Because somebody from...
in the rickshaw community. I can't help you anywhere else.
Yeah, I could never find that auto driver.
Who called you? Abodh?
It wasn't... Oh, no, actually, Abodh helped me out.
Very mature, actually, doesn't overreact to all this.
He was lovely, but some person posing As a fake WSD person, send me a big
right
fake.
Wingers
as
are everywhere.
As a WSD person,
wingers are everywhere.
They've infiltrated the WSD.
This is more a philosophy issue than what it is.
Because people are just
getting more angry than they should.
Yeah.
If someone has made a mistake, they made a mistake, you put it in perspective. They haven't. You're trying to help the dog and you did the wrong thing. You didn't try to hurt the dog and do the wrong thing. But why can't they go after those who hurt animals and do the wrong things?
Exactly.
And there are plenty.
We found the dog, but then eventually it's brought back to Varsova.
Superb.
Yeah, all's right. Well. That
but you try this with your relatives, huh? They also don't like it. An old uncle, you take him out of, let's say, Vashi, and then you put him in, say, Varsova, not happy.
Of course not.
Unless you put a nice old female relative with him.
What if he doesn't like her?
Then they may have children just like you. So be careful. Sorry, if he... Oh.
No, I was just saying that.
Why are you taking this further?
It was a bad joke, which I stopped myself.
I'm just
myself
making your
right
show
there.
Look good. Just keep
just
doing this.
Stopped myself before it got
guys,
worse.
Can you tell us about the show? You're just
okay,
going on
yeah,
talking
yeah,
about
yeah, yeah,
rickshaws
yeah.
and...
No, Tash, we got to talk about the show.
Cyrus is out of
Tash?
Control.
Who's Tash?
Tash, sorry.
Hey,
Tasha.
Stop. I didn't know this story is interesting.
Tash.
Your pet name is Tash.
She calls me Tash. Okay, so Ayushi is the only
what does everybody
person.
Call her?
Rytasha.
Only you call her Tash.
It's my personal nickname.
Personal,
for...
is it?
Yes.
Okay, I got it. So, wow. In school, what was she called?
Tash.
Ayushi and I
so then it's not your personal nickname.
No,
she called me Tash
since years.
And the rest?
Rytasha.
But it's a three-syllable name. There has to be a common...
People call her Ritz.
Yeah, Ritz is the most common one.
I would go with Ritz also. It seems... You're lazy. Why go... Beyond, you know.
Ah, matlab, aap to cool ho hi nahi.
Correct.
Aap to Ritz hi bologe.
I correct. Wanted to like really.
That's why I like the Punjab.
Your nose in the air kind of nickname, like Tash.
Ayushi's very fancy and uppity, as you can tell.
I can tell, but if she was Punjabi from deep in the Punjab, they'll take an Amanjot and make him Bobby, and there's no connection. That is fun for me because you spend 3 days trying to figure out what is connect. Why? Vicky, kaisa ho gaya? Hello, Bhupender, how are you, Vicky? There's just no connect. It's lovely. Where were we?
Our story.
Your
we
story.
We went to the same school.
Suddenly seems boring now after all
the
fun we've had.
Yeah, this is so like weird.
All that thing.
You keep interrupting our story.
Tasha the Great.
Tasha
the
just
last Tsarina of whatever that country is called next to Georgia.
Dude, that, you know, by the way, that's legit where I got the nickname from.
What?
I was reading I was reading something where there was a Russian character and her nickname was Tash and it was based from Natasha and I was like, oh my God, that's a great nickname for
technically,
you.
Technically, isn't it Nastasia?
Now that all I do is Natasha and
sir, we are India, so we will say Natasha.
But Hindi, Rus, bhai bhai and all that, what happened?
What? Raj Kapoor gaya, to wo bhi
that's
gaya.
True. So what you saying is that grandfathers liked India?
Yeah.
Right now, they don't
we
give
don't.
A damn.
Nobody cares.
It's a KLPD once again.
Woo! What a recall. What a recall,
thank
Cyrus.
You,
are you a comedian?
I'm not a comedian. I'm just a member of Google.
Wow.
Where were we? You're
we
going to tell us about
the show.
I'm going to pause Cyrus. Ayushi's going to tell us about the show.
No,
you're going to sell the show nicely here.
Okay, I got it. I'm on it. Essentially, both of us don't know how to adult. So they've given us a show where we tell people these are our 5 points. This is what we did. 3 of them didn't work. This is what you can try. And every week it's a different topic. And we're figuring
for example,
it out.
To speak Marathi for a minute. For example, what we do?
First, give me problem, I give you solution.
But adult problem.
Adult problem.
No, now he's going to give some.
No, I'll tell you.
Why?
In the last couple of years, I've started urinating a lot.
Okay.
Okay, so much so that when I take a Bombay Delhi flight, I pee 3 times.
But that's
No, it's a little embarrassing.
That's bad.
No, it's a 1 hour, 45, 50 minute flight. From the time I'm on the seat sitting, I'm saying. It's a bit too much. I've seen older people, much older people, they go maybe twice.
Like the uncle you dropped off in Vashi, he's peeing this
he's,
much.
Yeah, exactly. So he's like, ha, 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 he's going to die first, you know, that kind of thing.
So this is your problem.
Here's my problem.
Okay, first things first. If you're urinating a lot, are you also thirsty? Because then you might have to check like some.
No,
diabetes.
I do consume lots of liquids and all that, but I have been consuming lots of liquids for a long time. So that's not the issue. That's a terrible answer. Please help me.
Okay, fine.
Your science is what goes in has
to
come out.
You need to go to a nephrologist.
Yeah, it's your kidneys.
Like a dead person.
A nephrologist.
A nephrologist. Okay.
A kidney
necrophilia,
specialist.
Totally different thing.
But I see. I have all kinds of issues. I don't like male doctors. I like female doctors.
I
have to find a female doctor.
Yes, there's one at Jaslok Hospital. I just saw her the other day. She's a nephrologist.
Do you have a picture?
On the second floor.
Is there
you
a
can
picture?
Meet her.
I need to see a picture.
This is not a dating profile.
No, but they get very intimate.
You need to go on Bumble, I think.
Yes, maybe. See,
you'll find one there.
Don't you feel it's very intimate when you go to a doctor? Take off your shirt, take off your pant, hold this, hold that.
What doctor are you going to? Why did you have
every time I have
everything?
A cold, they check my anus for some reason. I'm just putting it out there.
No, your doctor is the problem here.
Was actually a trained vet. To save money, we do the dogs and me together. So sometimes they just do the same thing. I've had my 7-in-1.
These are not adulting problems. These are some other problems.
You know what I mean?
Cyrus Brocha
problems.
You just
said go to a nephrologist.
Yes.
No,
a kidney specialist.
Because the adult thing to do is not ignore your health.
Yes.
It would be to go to a fucking doctor.
Okay.
That is the adult thing to do, which we've learned. Ayushi and I are struggling. Because we're 25, 26, 27.
In why you went so low?
Because, you know, I still feel 25, but I am 26 and I will turn 27.
If you're vague about your age in your early 20s, imagine what will happen when you reach my age. What fun that would be. Oh, I'm 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 39, 41.
I'm giving people a bracket. Like, I'm in that 25 to 35 range. It's
your bracket is the whole show now. You're just saying these numbers. All right. Okay, let's give a real example. Forget my stupidity. Give us something that's come
on. So now, we finished college, what, 4 years ago, 5 years ago? And nobody tells you in school and college ki when you actually step out of this umbrella of an institution how hard life is going to be. And for us, it's still
that's a very poignant point, actually. Suddenly switches from comfort
and
of everything
switches
to...
switches on and off. It's not, there's no gradual rise. It's kind of
just boom,
straight.
Throw, go.
And then the first thing you're supposed to, the minute you graduate, you're like, okay, now you don't have a job. Shit, you don't have a job. When you get a job, you have to pay tax. You have to save your money. You have to do this. And it's just, it got too much.
The balance, like, because
you'll get an alcohol sponsor. I'm already depressed. Listening to all that you have to say, I can just imagine.
No, we're not depressed.
Sponsoring the show.
But, you know, actually, alcohol will be great.
It will be great.
Because
what else can you turn to now?
I recommend it as a solution on like three of the next episodes.
You went from happiness, mommy, daddy paying for everything, friends all around you. Biggest problem is, should I color my hair or not and all that kind of crap.
Still
and then
my
suddenly,
problem.
Still your problem.
Yeah.
And then 20 minutes later, pay bills, pay tax, figure out your life, how to go from here to there on your own.
We do a lot of fun stuff as well, which is we tell our dating stories, which are terrible. We talk about... relationships.
Oh, we'll need to hear one because that doesn't sound plausible otherwise.
Dating story.
Yes, please.
Ayushi, you want to give us one hot dating story?
Which one?
The new one?
Oh, no. Okay. No, that's still...
Ayushi has been on the app.
Tinder?
No.
Oh, that's
no,
my
one,
my
we
app.
Won't name it.
Lower, lighter, younger app.
Yeah, we won't name the app.
Love me, Tinder. What? Say,
there are many apps. Whichever one is for you is for you. But dude, this one guy that I went with on an app seemed great. Like, lots of things in
only
common.
Only on the app? You didn't
on
meet
paper,
him?
No, we went out. After speaking on the app, then we went.
You're not supposed to actually meet.
But he was on paper very well. Yeah.
On paper, my pop is 16. What the hell is wrong with you guys here?
What paper are you looking at
not
then?
Not paper. You know what she means.
So I went. And it was going well. And you're like, shit, this is great. This is nice. You're
describe
getting along.
Him, but what was on the app? What did he say?
So he was similar age, also had studied in America somewhere, came back.
That's all. He can make up anything.
No, no. He and we had some mutual friends because the app kind of lets you
so
see that you have some connection.
He was a real
connection.
Person.
Yeah.
No, in terms of what he was saying, the age and all was more or less
correct. Oh, that was right. And there are ways to kind of back
double check once he gives a name, etc.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Did all of that, went, it was going well, had a drink, everything. Midway through, he seems to recognize someone behind us. And he was like, oh, I know that person. I was like, oh, go ahead. Yeah. I said, go ahead, say hi, must be a friend. Yeah. I'm open-minded. You know, you can have friends. So he's like, no. I was also on a date with her from that. So now I'm looking at him being like, okay, I have to know more about this.
He's an app serial.
He's a serial
molester.
No.
He's a serial app dater.
He is. With
but
a
it
molester.
Gets worse. It's not, he's not even a serial dater. Like about 15 minutes later, he's like, I guess I should tell you something. I'm like, oh, this is going to be epic. He's like, I'm writing a 10-part series on Tinder, but I'm going on 10 Tinder dates and I'm writing about my experience of dating in Bombay and Tinder and what it means in India because I'd just come out at the time. And I'm looking at him like, but my first question after all of this was, what number am I? Because I was so intrigued before being offended. I was like, Nini, but where am I on
enough.
This list?
What was the answer?
He was very shocked that I asked this question. Huh. And he said, you're 8. And I was like,
8?
Okay, so you've been through 7. I'm number 8. I was like, who behind me? What number is she? And I don't remember what, but she was one of the earlier
idiot.
Ones.
He called the 9 and 10 also at the same time? I mean, what's the point of that?
No, it wasn't like he wasn't doing it all in one day. He was doing it across 10 weeks and he was writing his experience on some...
But who was the girl on your week?
See,
she
I
was
don't
from
remember.
The past.
She was from the past. He had
so
already
bad luck
been
to
with
him
her.
That she, he wouldn't have had to spill the beans.
Yes.
If that girl hadn't turned
exactly.
up.
Exactly. So actually that girl, if you ever
saved
listen,
you.
Thanks. Yes.
Yeah.
Khulasa ho gaya and Ayushi dodged a bullet.
So now you and her are friends and he's gone forever.
Yeah. Like something like that.
What's his name, just for the record?
It's beep.
Beep, beep. So yeah, you know the question is...
Oh, you want to know something else? A couple of weeks later, he sends me the article. The one that he wrote about
oh,
week
so
number
sweet.
8.
Excellent. Good things, good things.
Yeah, one line just killed me. He's like, and I still remember these many years later, which is how I've carried it with me.
My God, the pain you've had as a cathedral school girl.
Yes.
On Tinder.
Because this was a severe cathedral line. It was, I couldn't tell whether I was attracted to her because I liked her or whether we just had so many things in common, like our background. And I was like, I've never been reduced to just my background so harsh, so quick, just.
Wow.
It was...
What an experience that is.
Dating in 2019, yeah.
That's what I mean. It's tough, dude.
It's a whole other
thing. You won't trust men ever again because it's always an agenda.
It took me really long.
Yeah.
Like 15 days.
Like 3 weeks.
3 weeks. Okay.
Then
I was
really
that far off.
Yeah. Like, come on. 2 weeks too fast.
Credit to him in a sense because... You know, he was doing his thing. So in a sense, ultimately the truth came out. Now, if you just dated anybody, you'd never know if it doesn't work out also what they were thinking.
That's
this and the other. So in a sense, you finished the article and that's it. That's what it was.
I have no regrets at all because I got this story out of it.
Yeah.
He had to write the story.
I like the number 8 the best.
Yes. Yeah.
Cocktail party winner. Give them 3 drinks, tell your story, everyone will be laughing and wanting to know more.
This is what I do. This is my MO.
I can tell.
That's how I've been able to move on
actually,
to like 9 and 10 in my own life.
Well, you already moved to 10. 3 weeks.
27, now 10 will not happen.
God. The epidemic will be back. Be very careful. What about your love life? We're only talking about her. How dare you get off the hook?
I am exploring my own life right now. Alone.
No, but you guys are giving advice on Agla Station Adulthood. You have to talk about yourselves. You have to be open books.
Otherwise, come on.
I'm in a bit of a serious kind of situation.
The rickshaw?
Committed. No. I'm committed, as they say.
What the hell is she talking about?
I'm committed.
It means she has a man friend.
Or a special friend. I have a special friend.
A groomer?
Yes.
I don't like the word boyfriend, so I've started upgrading people to man friend.
Man friend. God, that sounded terrible. No, why are you hesitant to tell us? What's the problem?
Because I'm a celebrity and this is my private life,
please.
Cyrus.
Priyanka, tell us more.
Babe, please.
Tell us about Nick Jiju, please.
Nick Jiju and I are very much in love, very happy together, but also, you know, it's another part of the adulting. Because when you're in a serious, committed relationship, it is not all fun and games.
Right.
When you've got to cohabit, it is a lot more than just those dates and movie night.
Also, the big problem
is
the copyright titling because it's Jonas Brothers. So how do we put her in? Do we cut her hair? Do we call it Jonas Brothers and Sisters?
They're called the J Sisters.
So now they're called the J Sisters.
Because the three of them have 3 wives.
Right.
Not each. Like, individually, there's
one. Wow,
you're
too good.
In all this, I just want to say there's a fourth Jonas brother.
Of wild sexuality. Everybody has 33 partners. Some of them are just clinical professionals taking down notes. Her life has been more interesting so far. You only had a dog and a rickshaw. I'm going to tell you.
But, like, you all went on an adventure. I didn't go anywhere. But, they're called the J Sisters.
Are you in touch with that guy still?
No.
Why not?
Why?
Okay, we have to take a break. Abbas is going mad in the background.
Oh, shit.
Can you just tell us his first name? That way no one can find him. Like, if his name is Anil, how can you tell?
Yeah,
his name is Anil.
You bloody liar. What's his name?
Anil.
Okay, I'll see the alphabet. You cough and I'll get the right letter. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Come on.
Get that. There are 26
Ganil.
Letters.
Ganil is his name.
We'll take a break. Back with Ganil and Anil in 2 minutes.
Are you constantly seeking happiness? Wondering how to make the most of every day? How not to let your inhibitions stop you from achieving your goals? It's now time to get your A-game on. It's time to unlock your true potential. Tune in to the Empowering Series with me, Zarina Poonawalla, to feel empowered in all genres of life. From behavioral skills to management skills. From health to relationships. From mental well-being to emotional well-being, and of course your finances. I've got you covered. With these tips and tricks from me, Zarina, and true life stories from my amazing guests, you're bound to bring your purest to the table. Tune in to the Empowering Series with Zarina Poonawalla every Thursday on the IVM Podcast app, website, or wherever you listen to podcasts.
And we're back. It's called Agla Station Adulthood. Ayushi, Rytasha, trying to tell us the truth about their lives and a little bit coming.
I am telling
you.
You're
telling too much. Can you stop?
I'll just back away now. Rytasha, fine. The floor is yours. Please.
Bolo, Cyrus ji,
poochiye. She's not telling us. She's telling us nice things. The dog is quite open and all.
She reveals about London and all, but she's not talking about
because
her life.
Because what's there to tell about men?
Stop scratching your buggers.
I had to scratch
them. Unless you're Parsi,
sorry.
You can't do that in public.
I am half Parsi.
But that's not good enough. Then, okay, one bugger.
Why are you lying?
Bolna. So what about this man, this special man friend?
Oh, nothing. So in terms of our show, it's interesting that we both bring different things to the table. Yeah. Because I provide...
The man friend answer is this?
Yes, because it is related to our show.
Okay, so she's more open about the dating thing and you do something else.
I'm talking about...
I don't have the man friend on a permanent basis, serious? So I can be open about the dating.
That's just because you are the one without the permanent relationship.
Yeah.
Why can't she tell us about her life?
Ask her.
I'm telling you, so we cohabit and we've recently moved in together. So I am going through this whole phase of, kaise rehna ladke ke saath?
Are you mad? You've never stayed with a guy before. Well, you should have a trial period of 3 days in a hotel.
All that, obviously, but...
3-4 days at least. More. One day, everybody, all men are clean. Second day it'll be exposed. I think third day is your important.
He's very clean, actually. That's not
He's
the
straight?
Issue.
Is he really straight? I'm just asking.
Maybe not. Who knows?
I'm just asking.
Clean love is why they're cohabitating.
Means you see in my house, you see how my son and I are, as against how my, I hate to be sexist, but all the throwing clothes, leaving things lying, crumpled, it's just a male thing. It's
you
in
need
the
to
DNA.
Train the men in your house, which
fear.
I have
fear
learned.
Is the only way. I'm scared of my wife, so I do pick up things.
That's very good.
Yeah, so yeah. You're kidding.
Fear is a good motivator in my home also.
It's the only F word we use there. Can't use anything else, ladies. So who's the guy?
It's not important.
Why is she so shy now?
Ganil, yaar.
His name is also Ganil.
Has Ganil got some sordid past? Is he like a...
No, Ganil likes his privacy.
Oh, he's very famous. He's married.
No, bhai.
It's a, like adultery.
No, bhai.
But you're doing all this acting. Tell me. Okay.
He's
we stop.
A sweet,
we move
lovely
on.
Man. We are happy.
Height, weight?
Tall, slim.
straight out of the Bronte
he's
sisters.
He's a model,
fantasy
okay?
World.
He's a model.
He works out. You can tell he works out.
He's a model.
He's a model, I swear.
Okay. What's his full name? Soman.
I wish Ganil Soman, yes.
Milind's younger brother.
I'm sorry, I only know the 80s models. So
Ganil
I'll
Soman
struggle.
Is
yeah,
my
Ganil
man.
Soman.
I'm married to
he
him.
He also runs on the road barefoot.
He does.
At 2
does.
In the afternoon.
Yes.
Yes. He packs the day. Yeah.
You see his mom running behind him also barefoot.
When can I sweat the most?
So when your guy is running, there'll be a rickshaw, a dog and you.
Yes.
In that order.
Bas wahi chalta hai meri rozmarra zindagi mein.
Fabulous story. Fabulous story. Now, I'm bored of your stories. I'm going only to host.
Look at our life. It's amazing.
Are we going to sell this show, guys? So now
yes.
I keep interrupting you.
You ask us a question and then you only
because
talk,
no, she
Cyrus.
Said so. She talks about the dating thing because she's
we don't
exploring.
Only talk about that. We have many. Okay. We have so different perspectives on everything. Also, she comes from like she's an actor. She's more in the freelance and sort
creative
of the media
industry.
Creative space. Mm-hmm. I have a different day job. I work in the commodity sector and trade finance. So it's a total like a 9-to-5 scene.
Wow, that's so boring.
Yeah,
no, dude, it's amazing.
I'm just kidding. Yeah, go on.
So, like, you have a very different perspective in the terms of, like, people who have 9-to-5 jobs as opposed to freelancing, how both are navigating kind of similar problems.
How do you all stay in
different.
Touch post-school and college?
We just ended up staying in touch. You don't have any close friends from school?
Some are dead now. You know how old I am?
Yeah, so, well, we've been best friends.
We bond at the funerals. We go there and say, oh, Rakesh, great guy. Yeah.
That's so
remember
sweet.
That time? Yeah, it's like
that's
that.
Really
we're
sweet.
Still in the time where we're making that memory.
By the way, Kripaya Dhyan DJ, you can't watch it. Not a visual medium, but they're holding hands for some reason.
Because we are absolutely
very,
in love with
in
each
love
other.
This is like Diya Mirza and Priyanka Chopra in the old days.
Oh,
they used to
when
hold
they
hands.
Were announced as winners,
when,
pageant
yeah,
winners.
They, were friends,
they used to hold hands.
When they were friends, everybody held hands.
They're not friends anymore.
No, not really.
Anyway, Ayushi and I will hold hands for a long time. It's
forever.
Okay, but now it's hurting my hand.
If
I'm
she becomes really famous or you become really rich, will it still remain?
Yeah. Yes, she is really famous.
And she
already.
Is really rich.
No,
so
I'm not.
Good.
But she is famous.
Just take your time, okay? Mm-hmm. Decide who's what. We'll wait. We'll hold
we
the
are,
show.
Okay, so the most fulfilling, romantic and creative and otherwise relationship in my life is Ayushi Amin.
Vice versa.
I will just say that.
From school?
From everywhere.
Will it remain besties?
Yes.
What are you saying?
And we've had a dream since 9th standard. So we used to sit next to each other in the 9th standard.
Right.
And we used to...
Which house?
Palmer.
Me, I was in Palmer. She was in
Savage.
Savage green, yeah. Palmer yellow orange.
What were you?
Wilson.
You
we just
Wilson.
Need red now and we make up all the whole entire thing. Yeah.
No, this part of the segment, no one has understood
then
at
nobody
all.
Cares.
Nobody cares.
They're like, how full of themselves? They must be cathedralites.
Yeah.
Having this detached conversation
we
about
to.
Insular world and nobody else cares about. Okay, yeah. Go on.
So anyway, our friendship started in the 9th standard. We used to sit together and like come up with ideas. Oh, we should
little
do this,
sketches,
we should do that.
Little jokes.
Yeah.
And
we always thought, ki, chalo, we'll grow up and do something
did
together.
You ever like the same guy? Because that can test friendships.
Yes, we have an episode about this. Listen
to it. I want to hear
it. You will listen to it.
I have to listen to it.
Yeah.
Our opening episode is about our friendship.
And how we became friends.
Over the same guy?
Yes, actually.
And funny, we are all still friends. That guy is one of our
friends. Yeah, he's one of our close friends.
Ganil.
Beep.
Ganil is a stellar guy.
Taking woman empowerment to another level. Males don't even have names anymore. Ganil.
Sub Ganil.
Doesn't make the cut. He's not female. Okay, so the whole show is people writing into you.
No, it's us.
Then how do you know
chatting.
What the problems are?
We know what the problems are because we are living the problems.
We have the problems.
It's only from your own life.
But these are problems that relate to everyone.
Right.
Okay,
like,
so because...
But what if males write into you?
Okay,
like I asked
please
you about
do.
Being and stuff. I can see the female perspective immediately. What is the male perspective?
We will forward your queries to our in-house doctor. My father is a doctor.
Okay, is he? Ask him. I've been scratching my certain areas all my life. And my wife finds it very abhorrent and, you know, just...
Unbecoming.
Forget turning her off. She thinks it's like a beast. A savage beast, yes. Or you know, Neanderthal man's earlier ancestors.
Manscaping is the answer.
No,
Itchgard.
It's gone beyond. No, Itchgard doesn't work on me.
Oh, you've tried it. This is not an endorsement
everything.
For Itchgard.
I have like a United Colors of Benetton when it comes to creams on my thighs.
Oh,
everything
dear, so
yeah.
many.
Yellow, pink, white, green, you name it.
Then I think you need to tell your wife that this is part of marriage.
I told her all. I've suggested all these things
she's
to her.
Still with you now.
I told her all men do this scratching. Yeah, she is.
So then this problem is
not a problem.
But she's not with me in the biblical way. Just, you know, with me.
The biblical way?
So this is causing her to not be with
biblical,
you in a biblical way.
How man
way.
And woman are supposed to be. Ayushi and I understand. You failed the ninth, is it? I'll come back.
Come on,
savage.
Biblical ways, exactly.
Savage, savage was a bit slow, no? Out of the 4 hours.
They used to be very sporty.
Sporty, is it? Full of yourselves?
Sporty.
So I'm just asking, male perspective, how do you deal with that?
I'm telling you can tell your wife that this is part of it.
Okay, forget my stupid point. What about men who... So how do you talk...
Okay.
How do you bring the male...
This show is not only for women, firstly.
Yeah, but how do you bring the male problem area into it? How does that come in?
But we do talk from the other perspective as well. Sometimes I take the side of the dude being like, yeah, I feel like this. We skew things in our own heads and we make these problems very feminine sometimes. But it's just a... adult problem. It's not just women who go through it. Men also need to manage their
on
finances.
On that note, though,
that
I would like to add, like when Kavita first, when I came on your show last year, after that, Kavita, the co-founder of IVM podcast.
Kavita!
Shut up. Everything.
Took my pill in the morning. Kavita, of course, yes.
So Kavita that time said, I want you to host a show. And I was like, what do I don't know anything. She said, whatever you... The idea of a podcast host is wait
if
and listen
to me.
If anyone's
funnier than me on the show, they ask them to host the show.
It's not
a huge problem because one out of two are. So now I think we have too many hosts. Go on.
So basically, she was like, you just need to be an expert. The whole thing about a podcast is the host is an expert. I was like, I'm not an expert on anything. I am, however, an expert on not knowing how to be an adult.
Exactly.
So that is why we decided, like, I was like, this is my current situation. This is where my brain is at. This is where my heart is at. And every day I am trying to just grapple with real life.
So somewhere the Bridget Jones Diary space of two
you are just
dads
flinging it in a big
no,
way.
No, I'm just saying but hanging like, out and discussing their lives more and the problems coming out from there.
Yeah.
How you deal with things.
Yeah, but we also have like, I think episode to episode, there is a
overarching
theme, there's
topic.
Always a problem.
Yeah.
There's a main like topic
so
that
what,
you're going to get dealt with.
Friendship, dating, adulting, beauty.
Beauty.
What is adulting?
Adulting is the mundane act of waking up and doing mundane tasks which are boring but necessary.
Like going to the toilet and stuff.
Yeah.
No,
brushing
but like
your teeth,
also like being functional.
Yeah. Mundane but necessary tasks.
So how to be an adult in this world?
Yes.
And
suddenly.
In 2019, in like a city, in this kind of age bracket of what did we say? 25 to 35, whatever you choose my age.
You just cut me out with that one sentence. Was I too rude? Just dismiss me. Abbas, do something. I can't ask them anything more. It doesn't concern me. 25 to 35, not for your uncle.
No. You have to listen
you
so that you can
listen.
Understand your own children, Cyrus.
Oh. I have never felt so humiliated, Abbas. Please point to self quickly. Never call them back.
How old are your kids?
My kids. My son 16, just finished the 10th.
So soon.
And not soon enough for us.
After 5 years, he'll be struggling with adulting.
Then he'll be chatting with you guys. But you don't take in any calls or anything like that.
But
I think that would also make sense.
We
now.
Would love
we
to.
Would
so
love
the
to
show
do
is new
like
right now. And we just want to like commit to our first.
So once Kingfisher comes on board, we can do all this.
Yes.
And all that.
I mean, other brand.
Don't give.
I think I'll go with beer because I think you're talking about life.
The
for
Bira,
life,
Simba, such cool new brands, and you're naming this Tutti one.
So you killed it.
How could you say Tutti
on Kingfisher?
Kingfisher.
Now we lost Kingfisher.
Also, Kingfisher is like such an Indian iconic brand. How can you shit on Kingfisher?
And it's given us one of the greatest lines in the Indian languages. Come on. All right. So tell us other plans about the show. I've stopped all conversation about the show.
Well, we have a couple episodes lined up, and then eventually we want to cover things like even finances, because I think, you know, when you have your first job,
integral part,
you don't know what to do with your money. You don't know how to be responsible.
And everybody tells you what to do.
Yeah, but I think it's nice to hear advice from someone who's kind of either is a good financial planner, but also someone who's attuned to this age bracket, because you do want to have some disposable income. It's your first job. You want to earn and burn a little bit, which is fine. Like, throw it up, blow it up, whatever. But also save.
Woman raps, huh?
Gully girl.
Also, gully girl from where? But
mutual funds.
Shall we call her Cuff Parade ka Queens?
Carmichael Road.
Carmichael Road ki Runny.
Oh, yeah. But also mutual funds.
Rich trying to be poor. My favorite type. Go on.
I'm not rich trying to be poor. I'm telling you
about your talking about us.
Your bestie is making fun. Why, you should be. That's Brutus.
This is normal.
Brutie. Brutie and the Beast. I don't know.
Lovely. I love it. I'm going to call our next show Brutie and the
Brutie
Beast.
Brutie and the Beast.
We trademark it.
Look, so very good point. So money, huge.
We want to deal. Yeah, we definitely want to get into those kind of topics as well. And I hope that's the one that actually helps people be like, oh, this is like concrete advice. I'm going to go and put my money here or something like
but
that.
But also, I'm like, we are not here to change anybody's lives with our chit chat and our podcasting.
Wow, I have dreams to do that.
I think you should. Indians really need help. Haven't you met them?
We all need help, but.
But we can't
reach ourselves. You recently got on off Twitter, which was a very good call. But as a person who's still on Twitter, people need help. People have
Why did
really
she get off Twitter?
A
little fighting happened.
No, dear, you know about my dog incident.
Because of the what's it called? Trolls.
Too many threats. Yeah.
But you can't come on. You know that. Come on. The opinions and internet, I mean, you can't take it seriously, for God's sake.
We'll have an episode about the internet.
I have
also
met so many people that I've known all my life who on the internet, their voice is just different. They're like Moses himself on the internet, but you grew up the shy, quiet
Everyone
guy.
Everyone is holier than thou.
Holier than thou, but so aggressive and militant and...
Because no one on the internet has ever made a mistake before.
No.
But only you have made a mistake, and I'm going to comment
and
on it.
And never trust your friends who begin sentences with, I believe. You have not written a
anything.
Book on law. I believe. I believe nothing. Oh, what do you believe?
You believe Tati.
I believe Tati. Now, that's a show.
That's a good show. Yes. That's a good show.
Let's talk to our sponsors again. Kingfisher is nice this time.
Sorry, Kingfisher.
But not the airline. I get your point. Yes. Fair enough. All right. I think it's time for us to go into the EMAs. But before we do that, one last thing. What's the next episode?
Our next episode.
The one that we can now listen to.
The first one.
The first episode, which is on the 22nd.
The next is also the first.
Yeah.
Great.
Oh, because I don't know when this episode will be dropping. But
so
based
this is
on
the
that,
week after Independence Day.
All right. So then you will be probably listening to our first episode.
So one second. Abbas, this is explained to us. It's 2 weeks after Independence Day for India, not for Liberia, which is the week after.
The week after.
If you're Liberian,
fun
then it's
facts.
1 week after.
Fun facts.
Cool. Yeah. So it'll just
Monday,
be about...
The Monday after your show launches.
The Monday after our show launches. So you'll get to listen to our first episode.
You listen to our second episode, which is on adulting.
The Monday after our show launches, Ayushi. Monday, our show Thursday ko launch hoga. Phir Monday aega, inka show aega. So in the next episode...
What a nice chemistry. So sweet.
Adulting.
Besties.
Adulting and
friendship. Nine-star besties. She's the bossy one, right?
Not at all. Yeah. Oh, please.
You're the one who makes fun.
This is only happening because of Rytasha. She came on your show. Kavita heard her
That's
voice.
That's Kavita's fault, not her fault.
No, this is a good story, actually.
This is a
important.
Good story.
This is our origin story.
You are part of our origin
then
story.
I'll definitely keep it. No, don't edit this.
Don't edit this out. Yeah. She came on your show when you had her on, and that's when Kavita heard her. It's like, oh, this voice, it's fresh, it's fun, I want it. And so she told her that she wants her to host a show about this stuff. And Rytasha said that she doesn't feel comfortable doing it just alone.
Because I'm no expert alone.
So,
you just wanted someone to pick and drop you, is it?
We live very far from each other. It's not a ride.
You moved to the suburbs.
I live in Madh.
You betrayed all of us.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, she's gone now.
Down she's the Subhash guy of her times. Has her own bungalow in Madh Island for special rehearsals.
Yes.
Huh? Oh, damn.
You
I did not know this.
Why do you think you moved to Madh Island? Money? Money's not the issue. Only because you get your space and you can do what you want. Your little kingdom.
This is like a
lot. Kim Jong-un started with Madh Island. See where he's reached.
Is this why you've gone to Madh Island?
Yes, I'm the king of
Madh Island.
We should
have spoken about this. You just wanted a space to be creative.
I do. I'm glad.
Is that what they're calling it?
Have it.
Yeah.
Here.
We used to call it auditions.
Oh shit.
Tell the story. So, yeah. Kavita saw and heard.
So, Kavita saw and heard, and she said, okay, we'll bring in some people. And then
I made a list. Well, not really a list. I had one person on my list, Ayushi.
Me.
And Kavita had said, okay, you come with your list, I'll come with my list. We'll see who works the best. Well, we recorded
a pilot
with Ayushi, and Kavita was like, wow, ye ladki badhiya hai, let's hire her.
Aisi chemistry nahi dekhi hai.
Yeah.
She tore up the list then and there.
There was no list only. Matlab,
but like, yeah. Like, you know, in my mind, when I heard that we're going to do this, nervous. I was like, oh my God. I just imagined Kavita test. Being like, yeah. These guys, nothing. Just sweeping her desk off and just my picture over there. Being like, I'm delusional, I know. But that's our story. You're involved in it.
It's a lovely
Thank
story.
You for bringing us
I
together.
I had tears in my eyes, Abbas.
He's lying.
No, I did. It just took too long. Otherwise, I really like this story.
As opposed to your stories and...
My story is only about peeing and nobody's helping me with it. Go to kidneys better. Go to kidneys better.
Nephrologist.
That all costs money. My point is, if I could spend money, I would do all these things. I want free advice. Advice is free.
My advice is free to you.
It?
Go to the nephrologist. Yeah, that is going to cost you money. It's on you, na?
No, I'll find a kidney specialist who... Each with
pro
me
bono, pro bono.
With me.
I'll find.
Has to be somebody somewhere.
In Cathedral Alumni Group, you'll find
yeah,
one.
Yeah, I'm sure. There's lots of bored elderly people. Who
or we can go to like Nair Hospital and all, but they don't charge really. But they ask for Aadhaar card now.
So, okay, what about Raksha Bandhan?
Even the municipal hospitals? Yeah, well, it's the same thing. You got to show your Aadhaar card.
What if you go to the... What if she sees you and the doctor realizes that you
it's
are...
the same one. Yeah. First year junior college. Not him! Stalking me 30 years.
She had bide you long time ago.
It'll happen now. I'm worried about if anyone of my children are in these places. Because I'm that old now. It's a little scary.
Oh.
Pregnant pause.
Pregnant
no double meaning.
Pause.
Yeah, 100% double meaning.
You don't know what it's like. You're 20-somethings. You don't know what pain is like. You think adulting is tough? Wait till you reach 40-something. Then you'll know what pain
Can't
is.
Can't wait.
See, the thing is...
No, no, I can wait.
See, the fact of the matter is your adulting doesn't mention body issues at all. Except, you know, like my hair and face. And
spoke about beauty.
Yeah, that's not body issues. I'm talking about actual organ failure. You know?
Oh, like that body
hair
issue.
In the wrong places.
You know what?
Hair in the wrong
we
places.
We actually discuss backaches because that's a new thing for
backache is because of the computer and all. I mean, I don't care about that. I'm talking about real pain of being in the 40s.
So you're saying like hair when, that's growing in places that you didn't want.
When
it.
You can sing a whole Beatles song and then start peeing. It's like that.
Oh, wow.
You know about that? I did the other day.
I think you need to go to a doctor.
No,
no, this is... I think
I mean, I was ready to pee. We're shaking up, baby, now. And then pee, waiting. And finally. You know, just at the part where he goes... that crescendo, that orgasmic moment, boom.
You need to go to a doctor.
I need to go to many things.
Nephrologist, please reach out to Cyrus.
But now we have to do the AMAs. But let's quickly mention once again, Agla Station Adulthood, Rytasha, Ayushi. It's like the Simon and Garfunkel of our
podcast,
times.
Yes.
Of podcasts coming together and doing their bit to help young people understand the world. They're not going to solve any problems. Just going to help you open your eyes and see things.
And
from
that we're here listening and you're there listening and we can always chat with each
and
other.
And like, please contact us with your questions and problems because we're happy to
engage
and feel better about ourselves if we know your life sucks.
100%.
By everyone's life is average terrible. Only
is a circle
below average as far as I'm concerned.
And some good days, bad days.
You live where, Ayushi?
In this beautiful metropolis of Mumbai city.
No, she lives in Mud Island. So tell me honestly, where do you live?
South Bombay.
That's not enough. Where?
I don't want people to
Road.
Find me.
Oh, you're worried about being stalked? God, how vain is this chick, mate? This is ridiculous. AMAs, please. I can't do this anymore. Every Thursday, starting 22nd August, you'll hear Agla Station Adulthood for the next 25 years.
Yes.
By which time, it'll have to go to another midlife crisis or something.
Inshallah, yes. 25 years.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another awesome week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you are not following us on social media, please make sure you do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. And also, just a reminder, if you like what you're listening to, take a screenshot of what you're listening to and tag us on social media, and we will repost your post. Also, please do tell a friend if you're enjoying a podcast which you think a friend would enjoy. Do tell them. I think that that is something that really helps us. I think that we do see, you know, I mean, like increases in listenerships when you guys do that. So please, please do tell friends that you are enjoying what podcast you're listening to. Last week, we launched a new show called Agla Station Adulthood with best friends Rytasha Rathore and Ayushi Amin. They talk about their journey into adulthood. On the first episode, they discuss crushes and female friendships. And on this week's episode, they try to crack the code on how to adult. You can also catch Rytasha and Ayushi on this week's Cyrus Says, where they talk to Cyrus about the podcast, what constitutes acting like a grown-up, and Rytasha gives Cyrus detailed instructions to reach Mud Island. On The Seen and the Unseen, Amit Verma is in conversation with economist Mohit Satyanand about what constitutes the economic crisis. On What a Play, Akash and Siddhartha are joined by fellow comedian Harmanpreet Singh. They talk about fast bowler Jofra Archer, the India-West Indies series, Ravi Shastri getting reappointed as coach, and a whole lot more. On the Edge and Sledges Cricket Podcast, Ashwin, DJ and Varun discuss the Gale Storm, Shreyas Iyer's beautiful knock, Virat Kohli striking a century, Steve Smith's injury, and a lot more. On The Origin of Things, Chuck narrates a short story about an old brand. It might just be the shortest podcast in IVM history. Check it out. On Marbles Lost and Found, Zen and Avanti are joined by podcast producer Janam Divan for part two of Dealing with Grief and Loss. On Mr. and Mrs. Binge Watch, Anirudh and Janice discuss Netflix originals Glow and Orange is the New Black, which are back with new seasons. On Keeping It Queer, Naveen and Farah talk about the differences and similarities between gay dating and straight dating. Their guest is Manshir Singh, a writer and web series creator. On our Kannada podcast, Thale Arate, Dr. Chandan Gowda joins Surya and Pawan for a conversation on the cultural politics of development in Mysore. This week on the Filter Coffee podcast, Karthik Nagarajan talks to the founder of Kriya, Praveen Shekhar, about professional speaking. And with that, let's get you on with your show.
If you have any questions for Cyrus, write to us on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. Or you can send an email to whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
All right, EMA time with these lovely ladies who've decided that they're going to dispatch pearls of wisdom to all members of the community, just females.
Never, no, everyone.
But I think males need more help.
We are inclusive.
My personal belief is males in their 20s need a lot more help. Women I feel, a little better with the focus.
I agree.
That's what I've noticed. Yeah. Especially when you talk about suddenly going to a big bad world and figuring out finance and all, because male ego is such that you don't want help.
Mm.
You've got to deal with that problem.
Yeah.
I hate men. Can we start?
Hi. man on the panel, another man.
Eid Mubarak. I don't know when it's going out, but a little late. But of course, he never brought anything, but I don't want to complain.
Morning, what I'll bring?
Food.
You should have thought about it.
Need some time to simmer and cook, no?
That's true. My other friends have sent. Biryani is coming home at 5:30 today.
Same. I'm so excited.
Not to worry.
That's
friendship, You don't have to, make a call. You just wish Faisal Eid Mubarak. Come, that's it.
I love people who send mutton biryani.
I already also got it.
Well, I tell you, the Muslim and Parsi communities always like to give food. It's part of the culture. I don't want to be communal, but it's part of the culture. They're actually very generous spirited in that sense.
I agree.
Other communities buck up. I haven't received anything from you, Cyrus, food wise.
I was not here.
Oh, okay.
And by the way, Parsi news on Saturday.
Right.
And we'll work on Tuesday, Wednesday or something. So, you know, it doesn't make sense.
Okay.
Many days have passed.
Yes, absolutely. It's all about dates.
Okay, the first one comes from Kadam Shardul. His question is, Cyrus, you're such a narcissist artist. You hypnotize your audience. I am so addicted to your podcast that all other podcast hosts sound boring to me. Why do you do this?
Now you can tell I've written this myself. For example, it's clear, 100%. It's evident. There's the spelling mistakes also. T-H-E-I-R-E and T-H-E-R-E. I'm paralyzed with those two words. And
why?
Everybody else gets, they watch my letter.
Why do you hypnotize your audience, Cyrus? That's the question.
I don't know, this is a very embarrassing question, because only my mother would write something like this, and this is not my mother's name. She's amazing. I came third once in a race in the second standard, and there were only like two people in the race.
Oh my God.
And I still came third. You know, I was, and my mother was, he came third place. My son, third, you know.
Typical mom and her son.
Indian mom and her son. Unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
The fattest, ugliest boy. Rakesh, come here. See my handsome son. I'm like, really?
Second part of the question is, are you secretly married to Kunal Vijaykar?
See, I don't mind the gay tag. Honestly, I have no problem with all that. My thing is, do you honestly think that I would go out with a 101 kilo, 55-year-old man who coughs all the time and whose phone is so obnoxiously loud? I can't stand people with loud phone rings.
My phone's always on silent.
Complaints right now sound like you are in like a domestic partnership with this person.
No, I'm saying he's very much part of the family and all that, but honestly, what is attractive about him? I fail to see that. Do you know, he's a lovely man, but he has no glutes. He's one of those Indian men with no glutes.
Flat bum.
And so it's like how the insects
The very fact that you know that
is
going to fuel even
that's
more.
That's fine. That's fine. Doesn't bother me, because you know, we change in front of each other in the theater, in the gym, these kind of places. I'm not one of those boys who goes and hides.
You have a bromance with him, no?
I don't have a bromance with anyone. I just can't stand the fact that anyone can think that I would be attracted to something like that.
Cyrus doesn't like to brother people or sister people. He said that before. No bro.
I can't bear it. But I got to tell you, that ringtone has just done it for me, because we were at a funeral recently, 2 weeks ago. And it's amazing. Everybody's pretending to be sad. And, you know, everybody's got their glasses on and all that and looking down and wearing white. It's all like fraudulent after a point. The guy who died was 91 anyway. Sweet guy, lovely guy. But, you know, he
lived his life.
Yeah. And then suddenly, in the middle of all that, bing, 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 bing. Everybody started laughing. He just killed the funeral. I was like, we're going to do this whole funeral again now. It's lost its momentum, you know. It's like a fucking comedy show. It's just wrong place, wrong time. Oh, no bromance, nothing.
All right. This next one comes from Nitin Goswami. He writes on Twitter, Eid Mubarak, Cyrus and Abbas.
Can you
sum up the working and drinking experience with the great Cyrus, though we all know he doesn't listen much to anyone? You don't drink anymore. His question is actually to me. Like, can you sum up the working and drinking experience with Cyrus? You don't drink anymore, neither do I. Yeah. Working experience is very, very professional, very nice.
Professional? Yeah. I don't think that word is being used a lot. Thank you so much.
Very professional.
Very sweet guy. Obviously, I'm holding his testicles from under the table, so it's clear.
Who's the...
No, yours. Okay. But my touch is so delicate, so you can't even tell. Sorry, ladies. No, me too.
Huh. May I ask a question?
Please do.
Is there a specific reason why you've stopped drinking?
No, I stopped drinking 3 Christmases back now.
Oh.
Yeah. No, I drank too much. Long story. And a lot of bad behavior. I went to jail 4 times.
Legit?
As in lock up, yeah.
Like legit?
Yeah.
That's wild.
So it started getting out of control. I do remember urinating on somebody's leg in an open space. And the boys had to, you know, then... That was really bad.
Cyrus, you're having lots of pee problems.
Yeah, so much
that
urine.
That seems to be the underlying tone of this.
The thing is, I didn't go to the toilet, so I turned around, went into the Maidan, and then I peed there where this whole gang was sitting, open air, I won't mention where. And then apparently, the guy said, don't urinate here, so I peed on him. And then, of course, shit hit the fan.
Yeah.
Luckily, I had lots of boys there, so the protection came.
I'm
just telling you one story which I can remember.
I got it.
We live in
LA. I can't tell you how many more.
It
jumping out of an open car.
No, it's okay.
Fighting is the least of it. Fighting actually is acceptable when you hear the other ones. Yeah.
Fair enough.
Oh, wait a minute. What about the girls? This is before me too. I don't have any memory also. Because sometimes girls smile at you and there's a lot of flirting and chemistry happening up till 12:30. Everything's good. And then you go into that haze of the devil and you have no idea.
So you must leave the devil then.
Yeah, so I left the devil behind. Now it's Bonvita. You want to have a drink with me, ladies?
Yes.
I get bigger and stronger.
I love that.
Friday night, let's go. Drink push-ups. Okay, that sounds terrible. Let's move on.
Okay, Vivek Priyadarshini asks...
Why did you say professional? That was disgusting.
No, I mean, because you turn up on time.
That
you
I am.
Keep
I'm
time
punctual.
To time.
Punctual and professional is two different things. Yeah.
No,
you and me are punctual, right?
Yeah.
I came in 3 minutes after
and Ayushi's office is 2 minutes walking distance.
Correct.
Which brings us to the theory. She came from Mud Island, I came from Churchgate, and we came well in advance. But
people who live further away actually on time. Actually.
Okay, use better English.
Like, reach on time. Arrive on time.
Yeah.
The next question is actually...
When will you pick me up? You can't say I'll pick you up. Pick you up sounds wrong.
So by the way, I think men have this thing. My father has the same thing. Don't say pick you up. Say you'll fetch. But what if when I say pick you up,
in the old days, pick up.
I
know.
Understand, but I'm not going to pick you up that way.
I know, but the context is like that. Don't blame. What do you want us to do? It's simple. It's fetch.
Okay,
but that's
fetch is
like a dog
for pets. Yeah.
No, you're going another.
I'd rather resign from the show than be fetched.
Exactly.
Yeah, I would rather be picked up.
I will not. Please use Uber. I'm not picking or dropping anyone. I'm deciding.
Damn it!
They also
Uber
pick up only.
Like, sir, I'm here.
Madam, after pick up,
I'm here.
Please,
madam, and pick up all in one sentence. By the way,
respectful, but then pick up.
Now they all speak English. Sometimes speak better English.
Nowadays, when they come at your destination, they send a message. I have arrived.
Yes.
It's part of the automated service.
No, they speak in English. I said the guy was talking to me in English.
Durgara was not texting me, I have arrived. It's part of the app to send it to me.
So being a cathedral light, I got a little, you know, competitive. Yeah. Instead of using larger English words. I just said, so do you have chrysanthemums in your house? And he was like, yeah.
This is why no one likes us.
No one likes us.
I
never mentioned
chosen
it.
To remain
from
quiet.
St. Xavier's College day one, I never mentioned I was a cathedral light till today.
Rytasha distances herself from it.
She has to. She's in Mud Island.
Yeah.
How many
people how much more can you distance yourself?
Really? Except Mr. Subhash Kai. It's famous was
again,
Madhavi
again you've come back to Subhash Ghe.
Well,
I'm going to look this up.
You must. Well, again, look up the facts.
Yes.
Was it because he has an obsession with the letter M? All his heroines used to have.
That's a good point.
Wait, is that true?
That
I'm
is
learning
true.
So much useless information.
But like, no, it stopped being a thing eventually.
Stopped being
a
thing. Yeah. So did Subhash Ghe.
That's because his films weren't selling, so nobody cared.
What's a famous movie Subhash Ghe made?
Pardes.
Oh yeah, Mahima Chaudhry.
Suhaag.
Tridev. Did he make Taal?
The one with Dilip Kumar and Taal. Yes, he made
Taal. Is also him. With Akshay Khanna.
Taal was
an
no. Taal was Akshay.
Yeah. Akshay Khanna, Aishwarya Rai.
I think Anil Kapoor. That's that peacock song, na?
Ishq Bina.
I'm going to tell you the South Bombay connections. That's why MEC said Akshay Khanna. I thought, I said, look what you've done. It's become a Subhash Ghe retrospective.
You are giving him a lot of bow. Please, let's
No, it's just what we heard. What do I know? I was never invited.
I'm picking
so
up
I'm
on
saying,
a lot
you
of
can invite people to your Mud Island bungalow. They're like that.
Of then course.
Whatever happens, happens.
I'll have a party for all our podcast friends.
And wear gumboots.
Yeah.
Just to fit in.
Okay, last question for the day please. Comes from Vivek Priyadarshi. Wow. Hi Cyrus, this is regarding the choice of having your recording studio in Khar. Was it purely on the grounds of technical merit, recording quality or the studio, or was it a geographical compromise between Malabar Hill, you and Amit, and Baikala, Abbas and Bhayandar, earlier Naveen?
Why do they know where all of you well, live?
If it's Abbas, me and Amit, by choice we wouldn't be here because for us it's the longest distance. But the proprietor's name is Amit Doshi.
Yeah.
We know
he makes these decisions independent of Abbas and me. Yeah. Because honestly, we were not taken into consideration.
I think we are the only three who come from that side of the
Yeah, but
the
I think Khar is more in the middle, sort of. Because people are coming from Chembur, people are coming from, you know. Yeah. So I think at the end of the day, we have to compromise and say Bandra Khar is the middle of Mumbai.
It's manageable.
Yeah, it's manageable. From where we come from, we've accepted this much.
Yeah, 100%.
But Mud Island, I tell you, Ayushi, is now you're pushing me. You're pushing me.
She has pushed me. She's pushed
and
me to my limit.
You know, y'all are laughing. But when we have shoots, and all my shoots are these cheap shoots with, you know, cheap everything. So Mud Island's used a lot. Whenever they tell me it's a Mud Island shoot, I actually go into depression.
But now you
I'm
can come
lying.
And stay at my house if you have a shoot.
No, this is a South Bombay issue. You grew up in South Bombay?
Yeah.
So it's difficult for you to think, Mud Island, oh God, I'm going to spend 3.5 hours. Because technically, you will spend between 3 to 4 hours in the car by the time you come
you
home.
Take the boat.
You need to take the boat.
And where do you land?
In Mud Jetty. Varsova Jetty to Mud Jetty. It's like a 2-minute boat ride.
No, that's just that bit. I have to reach Varsova first, which is 1.5 hours from town.
Yeah.
Huh? Then I have to stand in line, then get molested on the boat, then I have to walk from the boat to somewhere
that's
and then
such
reach the
first world problem.
No, one second. What she's doing is that Malad evening issue that we have at 6 o'clock when we're getting out. She's helping me with that. That's all you're helping me with. I'm still spending 3 hours. If this was Shark Tank, I'll have to tell you getting no offers.
I don't want also.
All right, that's all we have time for. But once again, let's mention the show. Agla Station Adulthood.
Agla Station Adulthood.
Who came up with the name?
Tash.
I want to say it was me.
Tash.
Because I'm part of the beard.
Can I call
her
Tash? I'm too old.
You can call her Tash.
Tash, the beta. I have to say it correctly.
Then you have to say Tash, beta. Tash, beta.
Papa.
What do your parents call you?
Ritzy, Ritz, Rita, Bubbles. All kinds.
How many parents you got?
Just two.
Oh, Jesus.
They're very loving, as a very sweetly. They ask
so where are the folks? Where's the family?
They live in Worli only. Okay, now given this address also,
so
it's very funny.
As we end the show, just for the just to put it in perspective,
yes,
family's in Worli.
Yes,
she's moved to Mud Island, so no one's visiting her on any festive occasion.
My parents
occasion.
Actually visited me yesterday. We all had like lunch and tea at my house.
They came to Mud Island from
they
Worli.
They had work in Versova.
Oh, there's a matlabi reason in the, on the way.
Yeah, matlab, now we've
journey.
Come here, we may as well go there.
That's fair enough.
They have to pee, so.
I think so. Otherwise, Diwali, they'll send you a rocket or something.
Yes.
Happy Diwali. From us, look
no,
up.
No, for big festivals, she comes into the town side.
You come to the town side. Yeah. You compromise as usual. That's
in
the opposite of Subhash Kai. From what I'm heard.
Yes.
What I can't,
oh, God. Aage padho.
But it's done. Show's over. Thank you for coming. You can go now.
Thanks for having us.
No. There's no time for all that.
Okay. Thursday, 22nd.
Thursday, 22nd. Agla Station.
Adulthood.
It's the best show ever.
Every Thursday from then on.
Yeah. Every Thursday from then on. Follow me at Instagram and Twitter on Bored Brocha. I'm so bored. I need your help. I need your love. I need your touch. Okay, just follow me. Okay, catch us on any of the podcasting apps, please. We beg you, we need you. Send us your questions on Twitter, on Cyrus Says In. Or you can email us, even if you're not female, on whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
And that's what Cyrus says.
Hello everyone, I'm Zane.
I'm Avanti.
And welcome back to a brand new season of Marbles Lost and Found.
A show on mental health and its stigma, and we're kind of making it an open conversation.
Pretty much, yeah. And we're really, really excited about this season because we have a number of guests on and we'll be talking about things like addiction,
grief, children and mental health.
Exactly, children and mental health. And our listeners have also written in
this
time. Yes,
and we have an episode dedicated to that.
Yes, and guys, thank you so much for writing and we really, really appreciate it.
And we're really excited for you to tune in on Tuesdays on the IVM website or app or wherever you get your podcasts from.
And you can find Marbles Lost and Found on Facebook or you can find Marbles Lost and Found on Instagram as well. The handle being Marbles Podcast India.
Can't wait for you to tune in.
Thank you very much. See you guys soon.
Hello everyone, welcome to Tech Careers in the new podcast series presented by Accenture. I'm your host, Shiladitya Mukhopadhyay. In this podcast series, we'll get you the latest and greatest in the world of technology that's shaping the future of business as we know it. We're talking intelligent platforms, cloud, AI, blockchain, extended reality, and a whole lot more. Every fortnight on Wednesdays, we'll have for you a hot topic with expert speakers from Accenture, talking about top trends in the space, how these are changing the world and creating growth across industries. And importantly, we'll tell you how you can learn more, build your skills and expertise to grow and stay relevant in your career. Episodes out on the IVM Podcast app or wherever you get your podcasts from.